And I'm going to show you what happens in the brain of a psychopath. A psychopath's brain, and Dr. Oz, you can ring right in here with me at any point. You were talking about it on your show today. Their prefrontal cortex is thinner. It's under-functioning. It doesn't work as well.
The reality is we don't know why that's thinner, but no question about it. The part of our brain that's associated with being human tends to thin out, and it has huge ramifications. I don't know if, Drew, if this caught your attention, but in so many of the primary reports of these psychopathic killers, they seem emotionless. They're very calm in the face of all this. It's premeditated, they've thought it through, but there's no sense of remorse. Who out there can think, and I don't care what's going on in your life, you could ever defend killing one child, much less 20 of them, without having a sense? So these are not normal folks. And
this shows the wide regions of the brain that are not functioning normally, the prefrontal cortex, anterior cingulate. Some of the more deeper visceral functions even are out. And Dr. Oz, I think you showed a picture of this on your program today as well, did you not?
I did, and it's stunning, actually, when you realize how these are important structural differences. And I didn't have a chance to read this kind note sent by groups representing autism and Asperger's, but I love, since you're an expert in the area, to highlight the fact that these are not necessarily the same problem. In fact, they're very different. Folks who have Asperger's and autism, they actually have empathy. They don't want to hurt people. They feel badly when things don't go right. They just don't have the social skill.
Let me put another scan up here. I want to show, just give the audience a sense of how complicated our various emotions and what parts of the brain involved in it. This is hatred. This is the red areas, the hot, very highly functioning areas. These are the areas of the brain associated with moral judgment. I'll remind you again, the prefrontal cortex, anterior cingulate, these visceral areas, very important as well. And finally, the area that is involved with empathy is something late developing and very relatively sort of specific areas of the brain associated with that. And again, these are areas that light up hot, and it tends to right lateralize. The right part of our brain, the part that's connected to our body, is the part that tends to be most able to attune to other people and the state that those other people are in.
The reason those scans you sort are so important is if folks at home are wondering how we're going to help figure out when people like Adam Lanza are going to be able to hurt others, this may be the future. It will probably be through brain scans that we'll be able to help families who, of course, they'd be grieving when they find this out, learn that their kids are never going to have the empathy, no matter what kind of great parenting they're offered. And
or,
when we figure out why that happens,
or
we'll help
maybe
a lot
there
of
are things we can intervene upon with those proclivities, with those predispositions.